All the cyclists were seen to be saving their legs at the beginning of the stage. They knew that the 197-kilometer stage was going to be a grueling challenge. The stage took the riders through Carolina, Hendrina, and Middleburg. After a long chase, Smith and Pierce caught up with the leading bunch, and from there on, they broke away and stayed out in front all the way to the finish line at Loskop Dam. Smith won the stage, but the 25-year-old Pierce, who has been wearing the leader's jersey for the best part of the event, retained his overall title.
Last year I was more of an underdog, so not many guys knew, but now everyone was marking me, so yeah, the dynamic changed a little bit. Also, having the leader's jersey from, I think it was day two or day three, made it very hard.
For Smith, the tour was a preparation for his European season.
At the moment, I'm still 4 kilograms overweight. I'm still prepping for my season, so in March, April, I should be on good condition. And yeah, I really enjoyed the tour for hosting the event. It was good, safe. We traveled the whole Mpumalanga, love Mpumalanga, and really nice to race here.
The organizers and stakeholders are content with how things panned out.
The stages were really tough. The temperature, the heat was incredible, but there was enough infrastructure to look after the riders. And there's a lot of youngsters that put up their hands and showed that they can climb with the best guys. Especially a hot day, a long day like today, there's a very bright future for cycling.
As riders, we also need this endurance, which we do not have often in South Africa. And I think you've realized that the heat, as well as the roads, played a tremendous role this week, the past week, but the riders did extremely well.
The tour is growing in leaps and bounds and attracted cyclists from Namibia and France this year. Mduduzi Ndlovu, SABC News, Loskop Dam in Mpumalanga.